In this video, we'll take a look at type 1 and type 2 errors in hypothesis testing. In hypothesis testing, based on the outcome of our statistical test, we either reject the null or we fail to reject the null, which is also referred to sometimes as accepting the null. So there's two possible outcomes where only one can occur in a given test. Either reject the null or fail to reject the null or accept the null. If we reject the null, we are citing against it, while if we accept the null, we are citing with it. However, when we conduct a hypothesis test, we cannot know for certain if the null is true or false. That's why we're conducting the test in the first place. Because hypothesis tests are based on probability, while we hope to make correct decisions, it is possible to get results that are contrary to reality, such as the null being true in reality, but we reject it based on our statistical test results. When we get a result that is contrary to the truth, this is known as making an error in hypothesis testing. There are two different kinds of errors. We have the error where the null is true, but we reject it based on our test. And then we have the other kind of error where the null is false, but we accept it, or using the other language, fail to reject, based on the results of our test. Now you should take a moment to look at this and make sure that you can see the inconsistency in these two statements. If the null is true, we reject it. That's an error or a mistake. And if the null is false, we accept it. That's also an error or a mistake. And these terms do not agree, as I just said, so that's why we have errors here. So whenever this happens, we have made an error if we do either one or two. There are also two types of correct decisions in hypothesis testing. The first one is the null is true, and we accept it. So if you think about that, if the null is true, and from our test, we accept it, then we've made a correct decision there. So that's good. And then the other scenario is where the null is false, and we reject it based on our data. So that's also a correct decision. Well, these are the two types of possible correct outcomes in hypothesis testing. Let's take a closer look at the two different types of errors that can be made, those two we looked at previously. We'll examine those more closely next. So let's consider a situation where the null is true, where there's really no difference between the groups. And to make this a little more concrete, assume that we're looking at the first year collegiate experience in males and females. Perception towards college, how much they feel like they're part of the experience at the university. And let's say for the purpose of this example that it's known that males and females, really there's no difference between them, how cohesive or how much they feel like they're part of the university on average. Just assume that for this example. But let's say that we conduct our hypothesis test and our numbers indicate that we should reject the null. So with our example, let's suppose that females in our study that we did indicated that they felt more connected or engaged in the university than did males. For whatever reason, let's say that we did a random sample, but we happened to get more females who were involved in sports and more females who were involved in activities or groups at the university than males, just by chance alone, and that those factors had them more engaged in the university, and as a result, our hypothesis test indicated that females were more engaged than males. So if we got that result here, but as I said earlier, if the null is really true, but we reject it because our data suggests that females were more engaged in the university than males, then we've made a mistake. An error has been made here. And when we reject the null, when the null is true, that's known as a type 1 error. So our formal definition, type 1 error is reject the null hypothesis when it is true. And our example again, there was really no difference in truth between males and females and how engaged they are on campus after their first year at the university. But our study led us to conclude that females were more engaged, and that led us to reject the null. So we rejected the null when it was true. That's a type 1 error.